Well, all right.
Yeah. You know this is a certified food. You know, ever since I turned pro in 1989,
when I signed the dotted line. Okay.
The words are epic. Come on, let me hear the words, dude.
The words
are
epic.
Come on, how'd it go? How'd it go? My mom and she said, baby.
Let it breathe.
I'm feeling them now. I'm feeling
Let
them.
Let it breathe.
I'm wrapping up. It's got to be because I got people who want to be my friend. People I never knew. People I never thought about associating with. I don't know what it is. Let's spit. Describe myself. Diamond Rolex. Gators on my feet.
Talk to him.
I got some pepper every day of the week.
Every day, Monday through Sunday.
Has done. Fingernails. Two,
I ain't got mine done in a while though.
COVID.
I don't know what to do. Must be
this money. It must be the money.
See, Wallo.
Look at my jury.
Wallo, let me describe this thing for you. See, I was really testifying about the lifestyle that I was living. And I was telling everybody, it must be this money. Because I'm the same old dude. But y'all tripping.
Yeah.
So it must be the money.
I know. Listen. You prime, I'm Leon. You know what I mean?
You ain't Leon.
I'm Leon Sanders.
You Leon Sanders.
No, see, what happened is I came up with the saying that if you pray good, they going to pay good. And if you sleep well, they going to eat well. And he remixed it to something else. That's what you did. That's what you did. Because you was playing for Florida State. Wait, I was playing for Penn State.
Did you do all this when you was in or when you got out? I'm just trying to figure out.
No, this was back in the day when we had the thing. Come on, man. When
the karate process? What?
No.
Jamie, you don't even know about this. I ain't going to tell you. I'll figure it out.
Jamie, listen. That was
karate fantasy.
Listen, no, listen. That was afterwards because you was in Florida. I was in Penn because we state brothers. Him, he went to Bump College.
You was in the state Penn. You did not go to Penn State. I told you this. Oh, no.
No. The name can be changed.
And I heard when he was up the state Penn, he was up there playing center. He was all pro center.
He's a hater. But listen, right now.
Easy, dog. Easy, dog.
But Jamie ain't play center in jail.
Listen. Right now, y'all now tuned into me, $1 million worth of game powered by Barstool Sports, man. We're going to get right into these sponsors so we get into the brothers, Leon and Deion Sanders, and we're going to tell y'all about back in the day. No, straight up. Listen, we got to promote that.
You can't give yourself a nickname in the hood. Hey, y'all know this more than anybody.
Give yourself no
listen, when I was in the
hood,
joint, man. I used to play the corner, so they used to call me Leon Sanders. I was on this. I taught you. The touch and grab. Where you touch a dude jersey and grab it.
No, I
taught you that.
You can't say you was in the pen and you taught somebody to touch and grab.
No, I said that.
Yo, he just always spicy.
No, before the pen.
I taught you to touch and grab. No, I learned to touch and grab in jail.
No, I'm talking about when we on the court, when we on the field. That don't matter. You. That's why you were so legendary. But listen, let's get into these sponsors, man.
Let's get to the sponsor, man. New Amsterdam Vodka. The official vodka for Barstool Sports. New Amsterdam Vodka was born from an uncompromising passion for great vodka. This commitment to excellence enabled New Amsterdam to produce vodka of superb taste and unparalleled smoothness. New Amsterdam is 80-proof vodka from the finest quality grains from America's heartland. It's distilled 5 times, filtered 3 times for a clean, crisp finish. It's New Amsterdam is slightly sweet on the palate. You could drink it straight up. Soda, juice, make a New Amsterdam mule. The bottom line is get you some New Amsterdam vodka.
Oh, he will.
I take that New Amsterdam with me on the plane.
Take this with you on
but
the
see,
plane,
one
man.
Thing about this, I got me some shades on right now, but these not the shades I'm waiting for. I got some special shades. Listen, felixgrayglasses.com/game. You go over there, listen. You go over there, you get some shades. Because listen, these shades, that me, I picked your shades out too. That's why I can't wait till they come. I can't wait till our glasses come. Felix Gray glasses, one thing about them, listen, you try them for 30 days, risk-free. You ain't got to worry about nothing. I'm talking about order online, glasses shipped directly with the hard case and lens cloth. Like, you know about lens cloth.
I know about lens cloth.
See, everybody don't know about them. See, you don't know. Me and Deion and Leon.
Is that how you clean your jewelry? With the lens cloth? To make sure
it's fine?
No,
I clean my jewelry with toothpaste. Because with toothpaste,
okay.
it activate the diamonds.
Right.
Yeah.
What about the gold?
I don't know if there's 4-carat gold. I don't know what he got going on.
No, these nuggets. He don't know about the nuggets, D. Tell him. That's that player shit. Back in the day, we used to rock nugget rings. See, you young.
Now, you are right about that.
Nugget
back in the day. You are right about that.
We kept a little knot on.
This ain't back in the day.
Let me tell you something. This chain, this right here.
Yeah, they did. They put the rubber band around.
He got a five on top.
No, it don't matter. It's rubber band.
He got five on it. It's right here. He's still stuck in the day. He got five on it. I mean, song.
I got five on it.
That's what he talking about.
You know what I'm saying? I got a knot, though, and I got the diamonds on. Who going to turn that down? But I'm going to say this one thing about Felix Gray. Glasses.com. You go there, use a, you know, code GAME, /game. Listen, man, y'all here, they're going to take you to another place you've never been before. And that's what it's about. But also, for a lot of you guys out there that can't, you know, you arrive at the party, but you still ain't there. And a woman's like, oh, I thought you was coming to the party. And you didn't know how to party. What you need, listen, man, these Roman swipes, man, change your life.
I heard you talking about them, dog.
They change, yeah, he used them. The Tootie hit me one time and said, could you send me some of that for Yeah, Tootie said,
lied. He put some Tootie said,
your cousin is coming up short.
Don't believe that.
He coming up short in the bathroom department. I sent him some swipes. He went over there. He said, listen, all you got to do is swipe it. Listen, let it dry. And listen, party time. You swipe, I'm talking about, listen, it will bring the dead to life. Brought you back. You almost lost Tootie. You almost lost your cutie, Tootie, because you couldn't. You think
Tootie
right.
Called him.
She said, "Cuz, say because
he be putting smut on my name."
No, she heard me. She's like, "Listen, man, listen. All you gotta do. I'm talking about any coming to little. I'm talking about they small. You can hide them in your wallet. I'm talking about easy to use, fast acting. Listen, don't require a prescription. So you ain't that was so good about it because you was like, Tootie's like, do we need a prescription? I said, no, it's cool. I'm gonna just send you a bundle of them. I have my people over there at Get Romans.
Bundle,
I sent him a bundle. Because she said he been out the game for four quarters. He was out the game for the four quarters. He was out the game for the whole four quarters. So if you out the game and you want to get in and you want to be an MVP, like I made him, he went from, you know, a bench player to MVP. Listen, go to GetRoman.com/million. The first month of swipes for just $5, man. GetRoman/.
That's why he had five on the top.
GetRoman.com/million. But listen, man, we're going to get into this, man. We got Primo here. He got the new podcast. Listen, what you got to do, you got to go over there, get with Prime. You got to subscribe. You got to rate and you got to review. Tell them where they got to go at, Prime and Jamie. Tell them what's going on, y'all.
Well, it's the world's only Primecast.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. Ooh. It's the world's only podcast. It's not a podcast.
It's a Primecast.
Now, you can go where you get your podcast to download the Primecast, but it's the world's only Primecast. Jamie. We dropped that September 21st. You know that? Mm-hmm. Only made sense. I mean, 21st. You know,
Made sense.
21st.
Yes, you know. You see it, baby?
Yeah, and so we might have the Dookie chain on. We may not go with the Dookie roll.
89, baby.
You know what I'm saying?
That's authentic. That's the only thing on you, authentic.
Yeah, right. That's the only thing.
Oh, my jewelry.
Because the Adidas sweatpants came from Rawls.
My diamonds is authentic.
Some Adidas sweatpants came from
Rawls. Hold on. And nothing wrong with Rawls. It ain't. Rawls and Marshall's a cousin.
But you know they be bootlegged Adidas sweatpants. They get all the sweatpants that something they only had two stripes. Came out with two stripes on it.
One leg shorter than the other.
You know what's crazy though? I never really told you, D, right? They call me, you know what I mean? Because the way I did my jail time, they said I did my time in Prime, so they used to call me Prime Time. Because I had like a bunch of jobs in the joint, you know,
He had a bunch of jobs.
You was prime with your time.
You can't say you had a bunch of jobs in the joint.
No, I ain't talking about this stuff. He going to lie on me. Okay. But I'm talking about some. My time was prime, baby.
He was a prison shower guard. a lifeguard in the showers. He was a captain of the wrestling team.
He lying on me. That's old. Don't worry about that, Prime. You already know he lied every time. You know what I'm saying?
Let's get in $1 million.
Let's get in $1 million worth of game, man.
Let's talk about. I want to talk about capitalizing your talent.
Woo!
I like that.
Talk to me.
You know, where I'm from, the ghetto. You know, you see many talented people. You know, oh, he was better than Charles Barkley.
Mm-hmm.
But he succumbed to this. Oh, he could have been the next Bo Jackson.
He could have been the next Leon Sanders, but he went to jail.
Not with the bullshit. He could have been the next Prime Time. But somewhere along their journey, they didn't capitalize on their talent.
They stayed left.
Ida.
They didn't take a left. They didn't take a right.
Absolutely. Right. Somewhere along the journey.
I like that. Ida.
We got a name for that. Go ahead, James.
No, I'm saying
I like that.
Ida. I mean, we all, and that's one of the things that, you know, we talked about doing is that story, imagine that story being told by Deion or Jerry Rice or Wayne Gretzky or whomever, because all of us have somebody or somebodies that grew up in our neighborhood. We all come from the hood.
Mm-hmm. Right. All of
y'all think y'all got it tough up here. So who's from where?
We moved from Philly.
Philly. Okay, so I can show you a project they used to have down in Fort Myers that would make Philly, in Fort Myers, Florida. Mm-hmm. I'd never seen anything like this. It was a project. And so you know how you see in the movies the razor, the circular razor, Stalag, which That's how they had, this is in Fort Myers in the United States of America. There was a project in the 80s or the 90s. Yeah.
One way in, one way out.
One way in, one way out.
Mm-hmm. Death trap.
You know, that's basically what it was. I mean, right. and so, but the point of it is, man, is that there's always been somebody that we've all known
If I hadn't had to stop smoking, I'd have done this. If I had to stop drinking, we call them Idas. And you got to understand, all of us sitting up here, if we hadn't stayed right and took that left, we wouldn't be here right now.
Mm-hmm. But so we could have been an Ida.
We could have been an Ida very easily because we all had a crossroad. Mm-hmm. And we all could reflect back, that was that crossroad.
Mm-hmm. No, I would have been in the league, though. I gotta put that out there. Everybody, like everybody know that. When if
what league?
What league?
The NFL, man.
Oh, come on, man. Not for long.
Leon, I saw, but here's the problem, Leon. I saw the scouting report on you.
What? Okay, talk to me. See this? What's going on.
No, tell the truth. It was the 40 time.
The
4-7-40 time is what kind of stopped.
Right.
It
and you giving them? They said you had heavy 4-7.
They said you had good hands. Heavy
you
hands.
Giving
they
them
said you had heavy ankles, man.
Yeah, but it was the 4-7.
They say you had gout,
bro. That's kind of what.
And they say you had gout. They say you look like you had gout when you ran.
That was my toes was tender, and I had a tender ACL. That's what happened. You got to come on, man. Give me a break. Like everybody know I had a tender ACL.
They said you had a little twist in your run.
Man, you know.
Especially when he came home from jail. He definitely had a... How y'all doing?
No.
He came home from jail, run up on the camera, top of, get up, wake up. Y'all shouldn't be sleeping.
I sprained my ankle in the field, in the yard. Come on, man. You know how that goes, man.
In the yard. So listen, man. To all the youngins out there, understand this. You get one life. You have to live this shit to the fullest, man. And one mistake, one bad turn left, you end up a Ida.
You got that right.
So understand that life is no games, man. You only get one shot at this shit.
Let us put it in a better perspective. We all know somebody that had more game.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. I ain't gonna call his name, but he was just as fast. Matter of fact, we raced one step fast. I beat him, so he get it out of his mind.
But he know who he is.
Yeah. He know he was a better basketball player because I was all state.
I know who he is.
And he was
Man,
he was unbelievable.
Yeah,
he was an unbelievable athlete. But what happened is, at an early age, he got caught up with this girl back in the hood, and her folks ran all the dope. Mm-hmm. So that enlisted him in the dope game.
Mm-hmm.
And he got veered away. And then once he got back on track, it was during the too late, but he still ended up going to a small college. And guess what? The Falcons grabbed him as a free agent. But since his history, he had a pending case, he couldn't even fulfill the dream.
Let me ask you a question.
But this was a bad boy, man.
He was a bad dude.
Let me ask you a question. And it ain't to me. I just need you to talk to somebody for me, right? The people that I need you to talk to me, it's these young cats that's coming up, that's getting these deals, that's getting more money than they ever thought they could get. They coming into the league. They got the girls everywhere. They got the homies that they can't, you know, separate themselves from because they want to still be down. I want to tell you that you got to chill. You can't come to Denver with me because you're making too much noise. You know what I mean? You know, the press conferences, because you got brands looking at them, want to give them money, but they can't. They scared. Like, talk to that young cat that's got in the game, got a shitload of money. He can't hear because the money's stopping him from listening to anybody. Talk to him real quick.
Matter of fact, I'm going to let Jamie piggyback on this, but that's a lonely place they're in because you can't hear. And if you can't hear, you only being led by your vision if you can't hear. And they can't hear because the money has clouded their ear gate. And they really can't see because of the noise and the ignorance around them. Ain't nobody going to tell you the truth because they're about on your payroll.
Mm-hmm.
You get off your payroll, they'll tell you 100. Mm-hmm. But even the closest to you ain't going to tell you because oftentimes that person closest to you want to be you.
Mm. And a lot of times the people that's closest to you is be somewhat in fear of saying the wrong thing and being cut off.
But you know, I want to take the other side of that from this standpoint. That person does exist. Those people do exist, but they don't exist, I don't think, nearly the way they existed when we were playing.
Right.
These younger cats now are more educated. Mm-hmm. You talk to the NBA guys with that money. You can't screw up that NBA money now.
They do.
It, I mean, but generally, you can't screw it up. It's so much. Big. It's so big now. Mm-hmm. But there's a lot of guys, what I'm inspired by is there's a lot of young cats who are making a stand.
Yeah,
this whole COVID thing and what I'm seeing, you know, the kid from Celtics, all you know, the girl, Moore, she just married a gentleman that she helped get released from prison from being wrongly in prison or whatever. Mm-hmm. Real life has invaded sports. Mm-hmm. It has invaded entertainment. And so, you know, there are a lot of folks, as you say, that are looking for those yes men, and they have those yes men. But I think there's exponentially more young cats who've seen him, you know. Young cats who seen the mistakes that you guys may have made and are listening now. Mm-hmm. Because see, the one thing because in culture to me, what I see is that one of the best things that ever happened to our culture is people like Jay-Z, not because he's rapping, it's the businessman Jay-Z.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's the businessman
Jay-Z. That business wasn't here back in your day?
No, no, no. Well, I mean, he started
not
the
like
business.
That.
No, we started. No, we had a hair salon back in the day. That's where we'd have touched that up. I'd have trimmed them lines.
It wasn't prevalent. It wasn't prevalent. Yeah. The business aspect wasn't prevalent in our days. Yeah. We had to learn by mistakes because no one wanted to give us game.
Yeah.
I mean, one of the most profound things I think I see come out of this podcast and come out of knowing y'all is y'all, every day you're on the street giving game. Mm-hmm. Gilly is known for giving game. My son has Rishallo reached out to Gilly for game. Mm-hmm. So,
shout out to nephew.
He reached out to me about
the game is not distributed like it once was. It's not like it wasn't distributed back then like it is now. Now, all us old heads are saying, hey, man, come on, man, sit down right here. Mm-hmm. Let me get this game to you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But you got to be humble enough to sit down and get it.
And I think also the knowledge is obtainable. That wasn't obtainable when we
were young.
Because anything you want to learn, anything you want to know, you can go to Google University.
Well, but even beyond that, I'd say, you know, like we should say, you know, the smartest, you know, when we talk about if you're the smartest person you know.
He's a fool.
If you're the smartest person you know,
you're in trouble.
You ain't a fool because I'm the smartest person you know.
No, so if you're the smartest person I know, I'm crazy. I'm in trouble. Shit, I'm done.
But there's more people, as Deion says, to give it. There's more teachers out there. There's more experience. I think there's a better audience to receive it than when we were younger.
But here goes the problem. What do you equate as to success is? See, success to us ain't all about no dollar figure.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Correct. That's correct.
Right.
Everybody's there is different. That's the same. Right. Everybody's there is different. That's why I'm always careful when I talk
Explain
to people.
Explain that, Jamie, because they don't know what you mean by there.
This place that is happiness for me.
Yeah.
You know, it was Cell Block 15. I got that, man. I know you enjoyed that. You know, that was your thing.
I was in the spot last night. I had a shower. Gave me flashbacks. Man, like, this, man, it's like a jail shower.
Yeah, just felt
tight. Because he was only one of my family members that ever called home from prison and sound like they was happy. You know what I mean?
No, I knew what
I'd
done.
You made the most out of your
apartment. Yeah, I had to.
Cuz, hold on for a second. Hey, nigga, get the hot water, nigga. Yeah, you crazy. Yeah, what's up, cuz? What the fuck is you up there?
What you doing? See, this the thing, D. This the thing.
You made the most of it.
I knew that I did some dumb shit, and I stood on that. See, a lot of people in life, family, it ain't got about go to jail. When things don't go right in their life and shit, they point the finger. Yeah. It's every mama, I was living in the ghetto, I was this, I was that. I knew that I had the chance to say, I didn't have to commit crime. I had neighbors, I had friends that wasn't criminals. I wanted to be a criminal, so I said, you know what? I got to stand on this shit. I ain't blaming this person, I ain't blaming the city. I knew right from wrong. I knew what time it was. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, fuck it, I got to do this. People don't want to stand doing their shit.
I'm trying to figure out why you the only one with headphones.
Because I'm DJ too.
Because
I DJ'd a couple situations.
I just saw that real quickly. I'm sorry.
He's trying to keep the wig on. That's what he's trying
to do. No.
Why don't you put a chin strap on that thing?
No. I got a DJ under my belt too.
Whoa, DJ?
Yeah, I DJ'd something in jail. They had like a little karaoke night.
He was on the turntable?
He was a three-time.
You weren't on the turntable. No. I ain't talking about that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
He the three-time Dollaz State Penitentiary champion in the talent show, though. He three-time champion back to back. I ain't even gonna tell him your name.
He hating on me.
He was His name was Tupac Shakur up there. No, but
no,
I'm
no,
spicy.
No, I'm just gonna
leave it out there. Bring it to the stage, Tupac Shakur. Hit him up. We're gonna leave that there.
Tupac Shakur. No, that's a good one.
But we're gonna leave that there. Hey, listen, this is what I need from Prime and Mr. Jamie Dukes, if we could get this. Starting off with Mr. Jamie Dukes. Mm-hmm. A locker room story nobody's ever heard.
Big time locker room story.
Jamie, you got one? Good.
I'm going to let you start one.
I don't really, because my junk is just.
You ain't never had to check nobody in the locker room?
No, I swung on something on every team I was on.
Damn, dude.
Only thing, we had this cat. Jamie know where I'm going with that. We had this cat on our team. This may have been the hairiest you ever want to see in your life. I ain't talking about head hair on your back, shoulders. You ain't see nothing but his face. That's how hairy this cat was, right? So one time, he in the shower. They called him Teen Wolf. He in the shower. They really called him. He answered.
That's his nickname, Teen Wolf. That's his name.
He answered. So finally, I couldn't take it no more. I went and got on the speaker that goes around the whole complex. I said, do not be alarmed. Nobody, do not be alarmed. There is a full-size gorilla in the shower right now. Don't worry about it, though. He's tamed.
When he got a haircut,
he's trained.
He get a neck up.
He
would
not harm you. But I just want y'all to be alarmed.
They had to shave him.
No, this is the hairiest dude around.
They call it a neck up. Yeah. Everybody else got a haircut. You come on down our salon, you know, we're going to give you a neck up.
Okay, Jay, what about, We had another cat. I don't know how in the world Jamie and I happened to be by each other because my lockers weren't even on the same row. I think I was over on the other row visiting one of the kids, just talking junk, right?
I was about
ready to go, and I think Jamie had on his clothes too. Yeah. We were just sitting up there talking, and this one cat came over.
Oh, man, don't tell that story.
And bent over to get something in his locker.
And he always bent over the same way.
He bent over the same way. It was like a provocative bend. Like, why would you do that in front of a man?
Hold up. So you telling me NFL locker room.
Why would you do that in front of a man, right?
You telling me the shower room in NFL like the prison.
Yeah, it was open. Nowadays it's different. But then it was just open. It was open season. He bends over, and me and Jamie looked over like, why would you bend over like that?
He was looking for something.
I'm not lying, dog. It's almost like he had the mange in his butt. Like, his butt was like you threw a cat at it. Like, you threw a bag of cats at it, and they just tore it up. And I was like, man, what is... Jamie looked at me. Hold up, D.
Nasty.
It was nasty, man.
Jamie, what was this nasty?
It's
like somebody threw a bag of cats at his butt.
Okay, so you seen no commercials that they have on, like, for the stuff that you had the rats. For Bishuwa. Yeah, help you with your situation, you know, and I've had it for a long time. I started rubbing the cream on. This dude needed... He needed to cream his whole backside.
He should have had a robe. He should have wore a robe in the locker room.
It looked like somebody sprayed acid on him and it was healing.
Like
he bent over like he always bent over. I mean, he literally would bend over straight. And I don't know why he did that. But
and Jamie and I looked at each other.
And his locker was right next to mine.
To confirm, did we just see that at the same time? That was the nastiest thing we seen.
Y'all was in the locker room looking at, like, that sounds like jail.
No, that's stories from the set.
Help! But see this mess.
Wait, we've been in the same locker room you've been in. It's a little different. Everybody, they were had a little more free liberties in the locker room you was in.
Y'all was in the same locker room.
No, the state school you went to, though. It was a little different.
You had to take a shower.
But everybody was still naked. No. There ain't nothing but naked men walking around in a locker room after practice because we got meetings and all that. So, no, it's Jungle City.
I'm going to tell you something. Since Shiloh called, you know, Shiloh, you do. Mm-hmm. And it's so funny because men don't think about this. So my son getting ready to go to college. So, you know, you having a talk and you don't got him right. You and your kids go to college. So I'm like, Shiloh, this is one part that daddy going to have to talk to you about, the shower. He said, what you mean? I said, see, son, like in high school, y'all nasty, funky. Y'all ain't take no showers with each other because everybody insecure. Mm-hmm. Now, college is different, son. You're going to have to do that walk now. Mm-hmm. You're going to have to take your clothes off and walk.
A butt naked walk?
Yes. Yeah. Because I'm trying to get him prepared.
I mean,
but you can't get there with no drawers on and take them off right there because everybody's going to say, hey, man, what you scared of? What you afraid of? Mm-hmm. So you got to prepare your son, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm preparing my son, right? And I'm telling him about the walk and all that, going to shower like a man, no matter, you know, if you low or high, no, you got to be a man.
just represent.
If you coming up short, you still got to be a man, right? Yeah. So I'm telling him about all that, and he called me. He said, "Daddy, guess what, man? I was on my way doing my walk to the shower, and the dudes on my road see me cut around the back, and they say, hey, man, why you going around the other side instead of going to the shower?"
Yo, that's crazy.
Get what Shallow say. Shallow say, "Hey, man, I just met y'all dude. Y'all ain't going to get to see my team lean on the first day."
Damn. What the fuck is going on, man?
Hey, you know Shallow talk just like that. Shallow say, "I just met y'all.
I ain't gonna have pull
y'all gonna see my ding lean on the first day."
"Man, I just met y'all, man. I ain't flashing y'all like that yet, man."
Then he said he made it to the showers, and guess what? They had curtain showers, Jamie. Best thing ever happened to college football. Now everybody has
I was
a
in
curse.
Michigan. I was in Michigan with my young boy C's from Camden in Michigan. They played Michigan State. I was in the locker room. They didn't have, like, I didn't see no curtains. I just seen, like, open showers.
Because you was looking.
No, I wasn't looking. This is before they got in the shower. This is before they got
he
in the shower.
Here, like, he in there.
This is after the big game. After
everybody here 18, right?
No, look.
Got open showers.
No.
But now, at Shallow's College, they got curtain showers. Yeah. So he's like, "Daddy, we got curtain showers."
Yeah, he said,
"Straight.
Dad, you came up in a
I
different
time." I was
happy
because you got to understand, the big fellas is, you know, most linemen ain't never been naked in front of
right.
no, like,
right.
That's frightening right. for a high school kid.
No. I remember when I first got to college and I was the only freshman on the team and we took the shower, everybody just ripped their joints off, they walking around. Yeah,
like, no. I'm so tough. Who prepared you for that?
I'm like, wait, this is how this go?
What? Stop mentioning that little college you went to. That was a little one block radius college. That's
stop
not
playing,
what the
like,
that's, he, that's not what me and D talking about.
All right,
we went to the big.
See, he want to keep downgrading my college, but it's
great.
But he went though.
Yeah, I went.
Penn State. You know what I mean?
Okay, so
you know how many campuses they got in Pennsylvania? You know how many campuses Penn State got in Pennsylvania?
So 12. What degree was you going for that you was there for 20 years?
Sports medicine.
That's good. No, you came up with that thing.
No, I was
that was good,
medicine.
Though. I mean, that was good.
Ain't nobody ever went to college for 20 years for sports.
So you wanted to be a trainer?
No, I kept failing because I was going through with my teacher.
So you wanted to wrap ankles and...
Yeah,
I was going through with my teacher.
He was definitely up there. Yeah, you're a little tight in the hands. Yeah, we
no, work, no, I didn't...
We work your hammies up. Out and then we'll go down to your calves and then you'll be good for the rest.
Full body massage.
He up there giving full body massages.
Yeah.
So, James, come on, man. We need a locker room story, man.
Vicious.
No, he gave them to you.
Oh, so you ain't got none, huh?
No.
Well, you had to slap up a couple times in the locker room. Who you had to check?
I whooped the dude... On every team, first of all. But I whooped the dude. I remember.
Did you ever get whooped?
No, I'm good with them things.
Oh, you good with
them? I'm good with them things. It was a cat in San Francisco.
Yeah.
And the reason I whooped him was the game. That's the game, the reason I whooped him. Like, we had this coverage called two-man. You jam the guy. You let him get in front of you a couple yards. Mm-hmm. Because you have a safety over top. And you trail him.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And you undercutting him. So, that was the coverage. So I'm looking on film, and I'm trailing this dude by 2-3 yards like I supposed to. Ain't nobody over top. So on film, it looks like I'm getting beat.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't even play the thought, the visual of me getting beat on film. I ain't play like that. I was that anal. Jamie, I don't play about my film.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, "Dog, where you supposed to be?" "Hey, man, don't worry about it. I'm doing my job." I said, "Dog, where you supposed to be?" "Over top, right?" "No, don't worry about it. I beat up with the ball thrown." We watch another play. Same thing. I said, "Dog, I'm asking you one more time. Where you supposed to be?"
That one more time.
"Where you supposed to be?" "Man, don't you worry about me."
And he left at it. You see, he knows what is right.
It was that
quick.
That's
the other piece, too. He left at it.
It was that quick.
He left at it.
You see, so he was looking for his right. I saw you looking.
That quick.
He left at it.
That quick. He said, "I'll sue you." I said, "I might as well go and finish it off then."
Right.
Another NFL player talking about, "I'll sue you." But... I got off in it real quick.
But
just for the illusion of you beating me.
But did you know left-handed people are smarter than right-handed people?
I never knew that.
Yes, it's a fact.
It's a fact?
Yes, it's a known fact. He didn't believe me, and then he Googled it.
He said, yeah.
Because I was trying to tell him, like, bro, you could never, like, you use both sides of our brain. You only use one side. You could never match me.
I didn't know that.
Yes.
That's good.
He didn't like that either. He looked it up.
Listen, let me ask you a question. Top five athletes of all time. Who number one?
Ali.
Who else? Five. Top five.
You gotta give me some time now. That's tough. Ali.
That's
a... Ali. MJ is definitely there. Mm-hmm. He's in the Mount Rushmore.
Now you call? Are you calling careers or athletes? I've seen no better than I'm torn between you and Bo.
Bo was
you and Bo.
But if it weren't Bo, it wouldn't be no Prime. Hmm.
That's how you look at life, huh?
Yeah, yeah. Bo. But I thought. Away.
How old is how much older is Bo
years.
Jackson?
Yeah, just a couple years. No, a year.
He's 3 years, about 3 years older. Remember, I was a freshman when Bo was putting it down. When Bo did what he did to us in Auburn, I think I was a freshman.
Oh gosh,
he was animal. Why you think
they scored 30 points in 5 minutes?
Woo!
30 points at Auburn. 30 points in 5 minutes.
Well, that's a good one. What do you think happened to Bo Jackson?
You only said two people.
Yeah, why his career wasn't?
He made the right choice by going baseball first and then coming back to football. It's just injuries. If Bo hadn't gotten hurt,
it might be. Yeah.
Why did you choose the football first over the baseball?
Because I love football.
But the baseball plays so much.
I know, but this is the way I did it. I went football first, then I played baseball. But I also played baseball until we were out of contention. So my deal stated when we're out of contention, then I could go to football. So baseball was really the leader, but it seems as though football was.
But I've always said that Deion couldn't be prime time in baseball.
Mm-mm.
That
sport wouldn't allow it.
Yeah, he could only be prime time and take the center stage and have the maximum impact in football. Now, of course, he could have done it all. He could have played baseball. He'd probably still be playing baseball.
That's my natural thing.
Yeah, he could probably still be playing, but he couldn't be a great player.
Me.
He couldn't be prime time.
Yeah,
you know,
right?
Because it didn't lend itself. I mean, that Carlton Fish story.
That's a lie.
Yeah, you know, just tell it. This
dude who played catcher for was it Boston?
Carlton Ball. He played a long time, for 20-some years.
And you know, I'm from Fort Myers. I'm coming up to the Yankees. This tradition of baseball, I don't know nothing about all this, man. So I'm up at the plate. I just got finished talking to this kid on deck circle. You know, like, man, just saying. So I'm talking to this kid while I'm warming up. So now I'm up to bat. And I forgot what pitch it was, but my bat flung out of my hands. I fouled up, foul ball, going up. It's in play, though. Bat flung out of my hand. It was heading towards that kid. So my mind was on that kid, right? And I wasn't running the ball out. So this dude was like, run the ball out, you such and such, cussing me to the floor. You know where we from.
Mm-hmm.
You know, dude finna cuss me out like you know me like that. We don't even know each other.
Mm-hmm.
So I got back up to the plate, and he said some things. I said some things. I said, man, I whooped you to death by him. Because I didn't care. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm still got that Florida
in me.
I think I was 20 years old at the time.
Yeah.
You know? And he lied and said I was in the plate drawing a dollar sign. That never happened. I would never disrespect the game drawing a dollar sign at the plate. Always drew a hat. We always played in these little leagues when I was a kid. So I drew my batter's box because oftentimes we didn't have a batter's box. So I drew a half circle. Then I drew like a V where my back foot was placed. Then where my front foot strided to, where I wanted to be. So after every pitch, I would look and see my stride level. And that was all thought
that was
process.
A left-handed smart dude.
And this joker's talking about I drew a dollar sign. And I say, man, please. But it was a whole controversy that the other folks bought. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't real.
So let me ask you a question. When you was playing for the Falcons and playing baseball at the same time, did you feel jealous and envy from other teammates or anything? Or?
Those my dogs. No. My dogs at the game.
Did you see the 30 for 30?
Yeah, I seen the
30 for 30.
But
hang on. I want you to go back. I want you to watch the 30 for 30. I know you were in it. But, I mean, but.
Yeah, see?
But go back and watch the 30 for 30.
Do not feed him.
And I want you to notice one thing. And he mentioned the other guy. That kind of is probably the problem we're having now. Where other people had a narrative, okay, and then they're not seeing the true narrative. Wrong is just wrong. It doesn't matter if it's a black person or a white person. You can't put a knee on somebody's neck. It's just wrong is wrong is wrong is wrong is wrong.
Right.
But these people had their rules and their traditions that they had, and they would do anything to sell it. If you notice on the 30 for 30, all right, they weren't the people that were in the conversation that were being talked about. Because remember, now Deion, obviously, from the 30 for 30, you believe he might have been doing something wrong by playing with the Falcons. Mm-hmm. No. Because that was their narrative. Mm-hmm. The facts were he wasn't even on the contract. But here's the other thing that nobody called out still. We talk about the media. We're in the media now. We're talking about integrity. Nobody still, even after that 30 for 30, has not called those people out who didn't have the courage or the guts to come on and defend or state what they did. I'm talking about Tim McCarver.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about Bobby Cox.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Okay. I'm talking about John. None of them would come on camera, and they get the pass. Why are we giving them the pass for not coming on camera?
Though. Like, they roll with me. None of the players. Those are my biggest guys. The biggest emotional moment for me in my life playing sports, because they know I'm not emotional when I play. I ain't to cry about no games. I wasn't getting down like that. I put in my work. I went home. But when I flew across country that night after that game, mm-hmm. after the baseball game, and I got on that bus, and those jokers saw me getting on that bus to play, mm-hmm. and they clapped and cheered, and I sat there and tears came down my eyes, man. It was like that was the first time you ever felt appreciated mm-hmm. by your peers. It was like, man, this joke of him, man. I just saw this joke on TV last night, and he here? Oh, we straight. We got a shot.
Right.
Let me give you even a little more. Okay, so y'all just got to know him. Mm-hmm. We've been in the building today. Go back in your mind and look at who he's talked to in the building along with you stars, mm-hmm. you know, and the boss, Lady Erica, and all of that. Everybody, he's always treated everybody.
He respects everybody.
Every single person in the room. It's always been that way. It just didn't start that way. You know, again, primetime, he did right. Hey, primetime that up, man, because that's what got us here. Mm-hmm. You keep priming that thing up. You keep doing that thing. But you also got to look at the measure of the man. Now, y'all know him better. So you know what I'm talking about, right. But people don't see. They see the glitz. They see the bravado. And they don't see the human. And that kind of brings it back to, you got to circle this all around, 21st and Prime. Mm-hmm. Podcast. See, I did that.
And I want to say something.
But the point of it is that's what, on 21st and Prime, he's going to let y'all both handle the lawgiver. Let him hold the lawgiver. Let him work out with the lawgiver out there in the country. When y'all come out there on the weekend, we're going to do our shooting out there. You know, y'all come on out there. We're going to do some fishing. Y'all fish?
Yeah, I do anything.
Oh, okay. Hey, bro, don't.
I fish.
With your history,
he
I don't just need to say it. Like
that. All right, he fish with his hands. He's a grab fish.
But I'm going to say this. I'm going to tell you something about Deion always showed me love just from meeting me on social media. The first time I meet Deion, we now Super Bowl. Atlanta.
Came by
he said, meet me down such and such, such and such. I got up early. I was there like hour and a half early, right? He walked in. I said, D, you want something? You know what I mean? Because he giving me a chance to interview him. You know what I mean? I'm fresh out the joint. He said, no, man. He said, now I know D from TV, but you know, you be around a lot of people, and a lot of people that celebrities, they don't show you that. I go to pay for D. I'm going to treat you to lunch. D. He said, no. So every time he orders stuff, I'm like, I'm going to pay for it. He like, wow, look, this is what he told me. He said, you trying to come up, man. He said, you trying to come up, man. Enjoy this, man. You're doing good. Let me appreciate you. And nobody never told me that. You know, coming out the penitentiary, you just trying to figure it out and win. And for him to be able to give me that love, I'm trying to tip the guy. He said, no. You need your money, man. You're trying to come up, man. You're trying to get
Let me give you another story. How much time we got? How we doing?
No, we're doing good. As you can see, he fell in love with Deion that day. As you can see, Jamie, he fell in love.
Nobody ever told me that.
I'm going out again and wearing on a dress like
gold. No, y'all leave my dog alone.
He showed me some love, man.
Let me take that another level. So, NFL Network. You know, Deion left NFL Network to come to Barstool. So, let's talk about how he got to NFL Network. And again, a lot of people don't know who I am, offensive lineman. That's just how it works. However, you know, we've been friends forever. So Deion was weighing at the time between going to ESPN. Mm-hmm. ESPN actually had a better offer on the table than Eric Weinberg and NFL Network. Mm-hmm. And it was something in his spirit. Now, I've been doing radio and TV. You know, I've retired in 95, mm-hmm. and I've been, you know, doing what I do for a long time.
Right.
And so at NFL Network, and I don't even think it could have worked at ESPN, but at NFL Network, he told Eric Weinberg, he said, look, I got a guy who's better than anybody you got here, you know, as a broadcaster. Mm-hmm. And I just, you know, and that guy's, ah, yeah, sure, right, Deion. They want Deion. Mm-hmm. So he says again, hey, look, man, just give this guy a look. So they put me on. Matter of fact, Brett Favre had done something. So we're talking about Brett Favre. They took something, cut it up. They played it 3 days in a row. Now Deion, my agent, steps in. Yeah. but the point I'm trying to make about him, the man, yeah. is that, you know, he has always tried to give to others.
Yes.
You know, I realize now in faith, you know, as men of faith, that Deion making the decision to go to NFL Network wasn't about him.
It was about
me. Mm-hmm. It was about giving me the Lord was blessing me with an opportunity. You know, and so even now, as we now take, you know, because they never let us work together. It's crazy that I worked on it for over 10 years.
They never worked together.
They would never let us work together.
Right. Mm.
So watch what we do
yes.
working together. But my point is that the man that is Deion Sanders, and I was saying this earlier with the big fella, with Willie, was that nobody has ever seen Deion. Now, y'all see him because y'all know him personally. Mm-hmm. But nobody publicly has ever seen Deion. The only time they ever saw Deion Sanders speak was at his Hall of Fame induction. That's the only time anybody's ever heard Deion Sanders, mm-hmm. Deion Lewin Sanders speak. Mm-hmm. They've heard Lewin, prime time.
Lewin, the middle name Lewin. Is French.
C'est bon?
Oh, it's French. French.
You got the gold jacket. I got a purple jacket. Let me tell you about that.
Is Barney?
Prince
you played
team?
Barney?
Yeah, Prince. I want to tell Prince. Prince, yeah, Prince.
Because that's the same wig you can wear for Prince.
It is.
No,
is
I got
Prince, tomorrow's Prince Day. You got 2-for-1 special?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to people getting an opportunity to actually understand
Jamie,
who.
They get it. The reason they get
yeah,
it.
Because they know you.
No, because if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be here, dog.
Yeah.
That's how that happened. We just having a
Saturday conversation.
Catching up like we do. Mm-hmm. Catching up like we do.
Yeah.
And it stimulated to, so you would do that?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you serious? Yeah. So next thing you know, they put the call in. When they put the call in, I got the call. Then when I got the call, they were there 2 days later.
Because D, we on the phone with him. It's like, D, people need to... They need to hear this stuff you be telling.
Yeah,
right.
Like I'm like, yo, man, we be having conversations.
Because we sit on the phone and we be on the phone for hours.
Yeah, we have some real conversations.
You know what I mean? I'm like, they need to hear this.
They need to hear you talking this.
You know what I mean? So
you feel what I'm
saying?
But I
kept saying in that conversation, dog, I don't have a platform to talk like this. I don't have the stage for it. They say, man, what you mean you don't have the stage? Oh, we can make that happen.
Right. Oh,
we can make that happen.
Because at the end of the day, we dealt with the people at Barstool, so we know. They good people.
Mm-hmm.
You can say whatever you want, but when you deal with me and you deal with me correct.
And it's business.
And it's business.
You know it, I.E. Business. We talking about business. Right. We ain't talking about no other shit. When the business is right, that leaving anything, and you dealing with genuine people that deal with you, that's respect, that's to show you the love, and it's a different game.
But people out there need to know that this comes from brothers looking out for each other.
Yeah.
So y'all looked out for me. Mm-hmm. So guess what? Now I had to call the big fella. Big fella, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
We back, baby.
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
And that's what it's about, man. It's about extending your hand. It's not about, see, in the ghetto, they take the mentality of when I get up, I'm shitting on everybody. Because I've been down so long.
Mm-hmm.
So when I get up, my mentality is not to help somebody else, but my mentality is I'm trying to stunt on everybody. I'm trying to pull up on you. We got to change that mentality.
Preach, my brother.
In the urban communities, man. Because I'm a person, I live by I like to call it the ladder technique. If I get to the top of the ladder and I reach down and I pull Wallow up, even when I come from off the top of the ladder and I come down, what does Wallow do? He goes up.
That's right.
So I'm still attached to the top of the ladder. Now, when he's at the top, you know, I need that favor from you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I need to call on you, man.
Yes.
I need to. We may look up 2 years from now. Prime may got the biggest podcast in the world. Hey, Prime, man, we need that favor from you, baby.
No, you
need
get that
love. So that's what it's about.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It's not about, oh, I'm going to get this money and shit on my brothers. I'm going to get this money. Ooh, I'm going to get this money and come in the ghetto.
But let me give you the key distinction here, though. There's one key distinction there. It's got to be natural. Mm-hmm. We've got to, it's got to be taught that this giving.
That's the thing to do.
But it's got to be natural to you. It's not to, see, you're not going to have to call Deion and say, I need that favor. Deion, y'all gonna be talking. Hey, dog, let me come on and do this thing. We gonna talk about this, right? That's exactly what's happening.
It'll be like, hey, dog, give me your wire information. Mm-hmm. Yeah, got some for you. But see, it's a natural. Like everybody up here, what you do, you give game.
Right.
Okay. Well, Wilder doing? He running up to the camera, giving game. Mm-hmm. Jamie has always been a natural giver because it's fake. He's always been a natural giver. Right. It's a fake. That's why he's trying to get off your finger, because your finger itching. That's why he's trying to get off. He's always been a natural giver. Jewelry. Everybody here is natural giver, man. That's the commonality that we share.
Shit, tear his pinky up, man.
Itching.
He's trying to get off.
My jewel ain't sizing right.
Itching like on the work.
But, yeah, man, so that issue alone, man, is something that we really, as black folks, because black folks will sit around and say, yeah, the Jews, look out for the Jews, and the Mexicans, look out for the Mexicans, and the white people, look out for the white people. We ain't no different.
We ain't no different, bro.
We ain't no different.
Well, here, let me ask you this question, and this stunned me. So, Michael Jordan's one of the most most accomplished entrepreneurs in sports. Mm-hmm. Okay. LeBron James, yeah.
Magic.
Mm-hmm. Tell me the project they've worked together on. I'll wait.
And he just dropped the mic, wasn't it? Damn. He almost made me cuss. And you know, he was professional.
That's sad. That's how I look at it.
Why wouldn't these billionaires work together?
That's how I look at it.
I'm watching. But Oprah didn't have no problem working with Dr. Phil.
But in their defense, sometimes when you get to be that person, you always want to be that top, and you don't understand it's a team. Like, that's why I love teams in sports. Yes.
But how can you give them the pass? They play the team sport. I'm not saying entrepreneurship creates an opportunity for individual.
Yeah.
I get that. But all I'm saying, it didn't have no problem. You pick my phone up.
But that's who I am, naturally. We just talking about that. You said it natural. Mm-hmm. It has to be natural.
You got to be natural.
Some folks ain't natural, and I'm not saying that they're not. I think they are.
They're great people. It has nothing to do with it. It's just the spirit of, but in other words, to go back to where you were, in order for things to grow, one and one has to be two. One and zero ain't two.
Right.
One and one, you know, one plus one plus one, the three of them dudes, that ain't zero. It's adding on.
Right.
The only way it can expand. Buffett's talking about working with Walmart. You know, I mean, we learned when we were coming up, when Time Warner did the deal that they did in Atlanta and AOL, all that stuff. The only way you grow, you don't have to merge, but you may have to collaborate. Absolutely. In this particular season, especially for this African-American environment.
Guys, Jamie, we in a culture that real folks don't get it, real folks. See, the thing about it, man, we ain't know each other, dog. We from two different walks of life, man. Ain't never been no street dude. Been good with them things, but ain't never been no street dude. Yeah. But it's something about them that just attracted me.
The people. We always knew each other because I told you.
That I just had to get to know. It's oftentimes, and I know Gilly do this too. Man, when I see something real, I pick up a phone. Hey, my brother, hit me up. Mm-hmm. What's up, friend? What you need? Hey, man, I don't need nothing. I just want to tell you I appreciate you for who you are and what you do and how you get down. When was the last? We don't even do that no more.
Yeah. Nah. I always hop in a person DM, man.
Me
and
too.
Say, I don't got to know you. I say, man, I love what you're doing out here, man. Mm-hmm. Just keep doing it.
That's why I hit Big Willie up, you know, because Willie one of my guys.
They just did that with 85 South. I remember telling, hey, man, y'all need to get together on a tour. But if y'all do a party in 85 South, back-to-back, y'all to sell out everywhere.
Real talk.
Y'all to sell out everywhere, man.
We love them.
I just jumped in their DMs, man. Yeah, I love what y'all doing, man. Y'all
good brothers, man.
Because at the end of the day, man, for us, this is not no competition.
Nobody.
We don't want to compete with you. We want to eat with you.
And everybody win.
You feel? Yeah. This is not no competition. Oh, we up against Joe Buttons. We up against 85 South.
People put that
we
out there. Against that Nori, out there.
We up against Nori. We up against... No.
Them all are
all
brothers.
All them is our brothers.
Right. We ain't with none of that.
Now, they might... You know, Joe might say some...
He might take a shot.
No, time, I love Joe. Joe, check him. He's a better rapper.
I got to check him.
But Gilly going to shoot back. Gilly ain't been taking... He ain't been taking no
bullets. One thing, he learned how not to shoot back in prison. he would. They run.
Why would I be shooting?
Get the, all right, you right. I'm going to my cell. You right, but go lay it down. He was to go lay it down.
Did you have any fights though?
Like, no.
You in jail? No, I was
no, martial artist. One time he
you
called home.
You're not a martial artist. You're not a martial artist, dog. You're not a martial artist. You're not a martial.
But let me tell you this story, bro.
You know
you
think he's Bruce Leroy, right?
I am.
Bro, let me tell you the story. He was 17, right? He got with the jail, right? Now, we never on the streets ever talked in no type of codes.
He still, you keep you talking about saying? That. Man.
Can he tell the story?
Right.
No.
We never talked in no type of codes, right? He in there for about 7 months, maybe something like that. He call home and say, "Hey, man, I'm getting to it with the Gizay Bizzo. I think my his ass on the Lizine." So I say, "What?"
You gotta finish Wallow.
You gotta say, "Prob, I don't know what he talking about." He say,
"So he learned that quick."
So he trying to tell me over the phone that he got into it with a gay guy. And he think his ass is on the line. But he talk about, "No, I got into it with the Gizay Bizzo on him. I think my his aches, my kids aches.
How you
my
get kids aches it, on the Lizine. How you get into it with a guy?"
No, that's another story.
No, tell that story.
Can I say this though before? I'm going to tell you some real stories. Because it was a little, but I'm going to tell you something that happened to me.
But how did it happen though?
Stories from the cell. This is what happened.
It's a book.
I'm young. I don't know nothing about the jail thing. So you put your laundry on your door, right? Put my laundry on the door. Because they go wash it. You be in a laundry bag.
His came back folded.
When mine's come, listen, I don't know. I'm like, damn, my stuff come back folded, right? I'm talking about prop my drawers in there. I'm like, damn, they hooked you up in jail. It's like a long, so I don't know what's going on, D. So I'm like, oh man, this ain't gonna be bad, you know? So that came back, and I ain't even gonna hold you. I'm young, I don't know. A little small bag of commissary was on my bed, right? I go, listen.
You didn't feel the setup then.
So listen, I don't peep it, right? So I tell my old head, I say, "Yo, man, my laundry come back folded and some." He said, "What?"
He took him down there.
"Your laundry was folded." He said, "Come here, man." He took me down to this old head, little short old head. He said, "Man, listen.
Name Butterscotch.
Listen, don't be folding my young boy's stuff." Because I'm thinking like, oh, it's going to be an easy state. The boy folded my stuff, gave me, he was trying to get busy. I don't know.
Right.
I'm going to be straight
so
up.
So while the old head was spitting to the dude that was folding your stuff, what were you doing?
What you mean?
Scared to death.
What the old head sitting up there, "Don't be folding my boy's stuff. What are you doing right now
scared
while he's going
to death.
On?"
You don't talk when your lawyer talking in court. That was my lawyer. I'm not saying.
I'm just saying, but what were you
doing?
You
don't know the law. You don't know the law.
You just was
sitting
there.
I didn't know the law, D. I don't know the law. Okay. I'm just sitting there like.
Wait, right.
That was your prison lawyer.
He had to be. That fucking guy. Prison lawyer. He was negotiating.
That was good, though. So you don't talk when your lawyer's talking.
Yeah, you don't talk to me. I'm just like this. I'm just like, oh,
so
shit.
So finish the story. This
was so, he said, "Come here, man." So when he walked me down, I don't know why I'm going with him. I'm just noticing my OG, knew my people.
Right.
So I'm like, so when I realized that this dude was trying to go on a date, I'm like, what the fuck? I was, listen, because there was moments in jail where I just was like, I was scared to death.
Stay on the same story, dog. Quit. Finish the story, man.
So listen, after he told him, "Listen, don't fold my shit, this, down the third." I ain't go front. So now I felt some type of way. So I go in my cell. I put my sheet on the door so nobody can look in there. And I just felt, I was so upset because I'm like, he tried to take something from me. And I took the bag. I took it in. Threw the stuff out. Unfolded it and all this other shit. I'm in the cell like, damn, this dude was trying to get me. I felt like, and I'm glad that when it happened, my OA took me down there, nobody was on the block. No, listen, nobody was on the block when he took me down there.
So nobody knew.
Nobody really knew. So I'm like, bet. So I was like, cool, nobody peeped it. Nobody peeped it out. You know, my kids' aches was on the Lizine. You know what I'm saying?
Your kids' aches is on the Lizine unless you gave away your kids'
No, aches. I didn't give nothing away.
Was he trying to take it? Or no, he just wanted it?
No, he was trying to finesse it. He had the food and the, what's the name? People don't know no better. He basically was telling me that he liked me. And I was like, hold on. I don't like you. I don't want to be a part of it. Now this shit is getting scary. Now jail is not nowhere to be. It's not, I'm young. This is some scary station.
So did you seclude yourself thereafter?
After that, man, I start hand washing my shit.
He went to the hole, bro. He lied.
No, listen. If I didn't,
so you just had your drawers in the toilet, just washing yourself, just washing the crack out.
Oh shit! If I didn't have that old head on the block, and I knew what was going down, I probably would put PC, protected custody. I probably slid up in there on some, like, you know what I mean? Like you said, I started fake beef. What? You want to die? I want to die. So they can lock me up, throw me in the hole, all the dumb shit. You got to protect your ass at all costs in jail, man. I wasn't going out like that.
So you ain't had no fights or nothing?
No, not really. I was in the
What does not really mean, dog? Is it no? Or yeah?
All right, problem. Just for the record, because all of our viewers already know this story. He had one incident. The guards got to his cell. Him and another nigga was in the same jumper.
He lying.
I remember that story.
He trying to say he ripped my jumper. Deion asked me, "Oh, who ripped your jumper?"
Yeah, Shallow told me about that.
Somebody ripped my jumper.
You know, Shallow called me screaming. Say, man, give me.
See, you got nephew listening.
Ripped his jumper, dog. That was some funny junk, man. I remember that story.
Yeah, he definitely got his jumper ripped. By the time the guards got there, him and the boy was in the same jumper. So he you know. But listen, man, Prime. 21st and Prime.
Let's talk about that.
September 21st.
Yes. Tomorrow. Look at it tomorrow. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, the day's the 20th.
Yeah, the day the 20th. Bet tomorrow. You know what I mean?
Oh, it's going to be good.
It's going to be good, man. Listen,
Jamie, can you give him a tease? Jamie. Give him a tease with that game and the draws.
Well, it's going to be.
The draws? That's sounds
yeah. Jail. You know, you can't give it all to him.
I just got my draws for
the real tease. The real tease.
Scare me, D.
Where you want to start?
Announcement tease. Like, give him a real tease, dog. Set it up. Come on, big fella.
Coming up on the corner 21st and Prime, mm-hmm. You're not going to believe what's going to happen. It's going to be the most incredible array of guests, which includes you guys.
Yes.
But starting off the 21st and Prime podcast, we're going to have arguably.
Primecast.
The Primecast. Thank you for that. Mm-hmm. We're going to likely have the biggest name in football on the show. Likely have the biggest owner in football on the show.
I already know, baby.
Jeffrey Lurie.
I wish you would.
He talking about Jerry. He talking about Jerry. Jerry was trying to get me down.
We ain't going to go there about that bullshit.
Listen.
I told you how it was going to go down.
Before Pac-Man.
But you won't listen to me.
Listen.
I hope you ain't better on
it. Hold up. Before Pac-Man, Jerry was trying. Jerry came and hollered at me in the joint. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. Then we're going to have, you know, and the thing about it, we've got these phrases and sayings that we've had for years. You know, hold on players. So we're going to have different segments. You know, Deion has features as well. You know, we're going to have just it, anything you see, whether it be sports, entertainment, we might talk a little politics too. We're going to try to stay away from that stuff. But the thing is, and that's what I love about this show, it's about people. Mm-hmm. Now, y'all are stars now. Y'all big time stars. But this is going to be that opportunity for the fan to actually get to do what y'all are doing.
We're going live too.
Yeah.
Because some stuff, I want to hear from the fans. Mm-hmm. I want them to give it to us straight.
You know, sometimes the fans come up with the best.
That's what I'm
trying
to tell you.
Yes.
It's like right now. Like one question I have in my mind right now is, and we got to take it to the street. We call it take it to the street.
Or
take it to the corner. I forgot whatever the name was. Is they keep saying ratings are down in football as well as basketball. Ratings are down. And some people are saying, yeah, because we tired of the politics during the game. We don't want to hear all that. Mm-hmm. We want to skate. Right. We want to see football or we want to see basketball.
Right.
We don't want to see Black Lives Matter. We don't want to see this. We like, well, how do y'all feel about that? Because it has validation.
Mm-hmm.
It's real.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how do they feel about it? So we got to take it to the street.
We're going to take it to the streets. What y'all need to do right now, y'all need to subscribe, rate, and review. Listen, man, prime time. Listen,
ain't nobody take you serious with that wig on. Get it? Can you say that?
Dog? Listen, man. Subscribe, rate.
You got a wig.
I like the wig, dog.
We wait.
That little hair in the front.
We wait. Get up out of here.
We ain't had no part in the front.
The little thriller thing.
Listen, we got to close this, man, because I got to go wet my hair, man. These dudes want to hate on me. Get the shit off me, man.
You shouldn't say wet your hair when you've been in prison.
He always got to get wet sometimes.
Listen, man,
you can't do that.
Check Prime out. Jamie Dukes. Listen, man, 21st and Prime, man. Listen, subscribe, rate and review on Apple. Listen, man, we ready to get up out of here, man. I'm Wallow 227. Got my brother Jamie Dukes right here. Got Prime Time. I'm Leon.
Hey, man, take off my jersey, please.
No, I'm going to get you to sign this for some people,
too. Jersey turning green.
Listen, I mean, snug. Hey, listen, we signing off, man. Listen, what do you say?
I go by the name of Gilly the King, man. We appreciate y'all each and every week making us the number one music podcast in the country.
Number one.
Number uno.
Because second place is the first loser.
That's right. So I wear my hats at least twice a week. Yeah, I know y'all seen it. Absolutely. My $1 million worth of gas.
Absolutely. Yeah, I got my appreciate you too, man. So make sure y'all go to Barstool Sports. Get your merch. I go by the name of Gilly the King.
I'm Wallow 267.
It's just like that.
Right.